Hey, YouTubers, guess what I got in the mail? Something I bought off of eBay, of course. And I got it off of Hiwin, which is a Thermodyne Systems eBay account. This is a 12-volt AC, and it's the MaxCore Avenger. Avenger, people. There it is. What can I say about it? All right, first of all, I want to show you. It's still, you can turn it with your finger. Yes, turn it there, look how freely that moves. Freely, it moves, yes. Well, anyways, this is 14 magnets, 14 monopoles, okay? And it has magnetic bars, force bars, I should say, in there, and that means it has 24 magnetic points on that rotor to the stator, okay? And it comes in a 12 and 24 volt. It's heavy core and coil has brought the efficiency up by 75% over and above a 14 magnet PMA and PMGs. With the narrow coils, it's basically, this has the power of two normal size PMAs, okay? So it's not two rotors that are separated with two stators. It's one unit so that you don't have all that weight, plus your hub blades, you know, on the end of the bracket that is questionable on other brackets I've seen. But this one, it should be able to hold up on the bracket that Thermodyne has. If not, I'm sure Thermodyne will be changing that too. But just to show you once again how freely this moves. Pretty easy to turn it. And on top of it, Thermodyne understands about, you know, being able to get the current to flow out of this without overheating your PMA, without overheating your wires, okay? Because if you're claiming that you're going to be making, you know, your 1,200, 1,600 watts, you know, 2,800 watts, you know, you better have some big heavy-duty gauge wire coming out of you, okay? About the size of that wire. Well, anyways, bring it back to the size of the wire. There it is, 8-gauge. And to top it off, Thermodyne's using THHW or AWM style wire, which is UL rated. And that's good. I mean, you know, it's what you need. You don't need 10-gauge. 10-gauge, it's a traffic jam. It's all sitting up here. It's not going all through the wires. They're overheating, including overheating. That means you have to have 60 to 70 amps to overheat that wire, okay? So your claims better be pretty accurate, because if you're getting over that, your wires are going to melt, okay? So when you see that people are saying, well, this little 10-gauge is just fine. Well, that's not true. As you know about restriction and wire sizes, you know, the resistance that it has, okay? So, this one's rated for, I think it was, let me see what I write down. Oh, 1,800 watts for wind and 4,000 watts for engine. Okay? What else can I say about it? Pretty much, that's about it. I mean, it's a heavy duty PMA. Okay? I want to point out too, it's still the 10SI case, which is readily available. You can buy it online anywhere, or, you know, if you want, you can wait a little while, and I'm sure they're going to come out with the stator along with the rotor, and then you can do it yourself, but you got to be careful because, man, there's a lot of power I mean, there's a lot of power by combining, you know, by putting that amount of magnets and monopoles that you could have a pinch belly attack. Yeah, pinch belly. So anyways, don't be fooled by fancy cases. This is all, I mean, I don't know if you could see inside there, but you see how well it comes out on that stator. You see that? The rotor is almost flush with that stator, okay? So there's no undersized magnets, there's no oversized stator, and on top of it, the cogging is minimal. Cogging is minimal, people, and that's what you want. And if I hook all three of these together, which I'm going to be showing, you can barely turn this. Okay. So don't be fooled by fancy cases and their claims of output. Go where it's tried and true. They've had it tested. There's further testing being done on it by a real testing company, from what I hear. So I'll be doing my testing, and first test will be on a 4-foot pole, but I'm still waiting for my blades to come in. I got some big blades that I'm going to be putting on this, and we'll see how she works. Okay? And in my dirty area, if it makes production on a 4-foot pole, you can imagine what it's going to do when, you know, for you guys that need to put a turbine up on top of the moon. You'll be amazed, I'm sure of it. But I also want to point out that they've got us. This is just a little spacer I put in here. I didn't want to have the lock collar in here, but this is specially made. This hub stabilizer is specially made for this PMA, okay? So don't try to put the other ones on, because they're too large, and you won't have enough on the shaft to be able to put your hub blades on. Okay? Well, this is Billy, and here it is, people. The Avenger, the Max, is it Maxalt? Yeah, I think it's Maxalt. Max Core, excuse me. Max Core Avenger, people. And I'm real. I'm not out to do any bashing of anything or anybody or any, whatever. I just want to show actual production and actual truth. Put it that way. Not sitting here saying, well, I'm going to take one of these and put it here and make it go with clink, 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 which, no, it doesn't do that. There is no fudging. Oh, hey, wait, I'm going to try to get it, put all these wires together, and then I'm going to show you how hard it is to turn. Well, I don't need an Allen wrench to turn mine, okay? You know, one of these Allen keys, you know? I don't need that to turn this, okay? I don't need that. And anyways, why would I put something in here that could mar up the wiring, the magnetic wiring in here, and then cause it, you know, to short out? I don't want to do that. And so, you know, let's use the angle wrench on it so it shows that you can turn it. Well, I don't need an angle wrench for this, people. Two fingers. In fact, why don't we just do the one finger? It always works better. It always works. I couldn't do that with that other one, that 14 magnet I had. I couldn't do this. I can do this with this big baby. The Avenger! 12 volt! Max Core, people. All right, this is Billy. I'll be showing more later. Thanks.